my hat. Forget the motherfucker. Forget the motherfucker. Forget the motherfucker. Forget the motherfucker. That is the mantra that is gonna keep you sane. Along with the Quran, chuck it in the sea. Become desireless. Desire must be overcome. Says stop while symbolizing speed. In time, your dick will get wet again. Sure it will, and you'll smile. I need a chariot with wheels of fire. All I got today was another nail in my tire. 1,000 thieves of virginity inside the flames and outside the sea. And in between you lay in a fitful sleep. The waves are eating up the beach, and beneath them, vampires, home mortgages, and black-hatted cowboys. The sea is death. Its blue is blood. The bones they use to beat the drums. And I can hear them pounding, pounding, pounding all over the island.
Yeah.
About 10 more. I was watching a movie today and I saw somebody say, I gotta catch a plane in an hour. And I'm like, what the fuck are they so calm about? If I had to catch a plane in an hour, I'd be at the fucking airport and I'd have packed 3 days ago. I just don't fucking get it. Somebody mentioned Johnny Appleseed, so we'll do 3 poems, but that'll be the fuck yeah. I already wore a hat with a honey pot on it. What the fuck? Alright. Johnny Appleseed, American Dionysus. Remember him when that cider hits your lips. When that sweetness cracks its whip. So red, so delicious. Spot it with a hawk eye. Sell it to corporate America. Wrap it in barbed wire. Build a cage around it. Dedicated sham. Oh, I've been alone. I've been dethroned. I walk through the poppies in the fields. I have been taken up into outer space. But even when the aliens dissected me, they could not get this mask off of my face. And so they sent me back down into your gothic garden, where the witches ride broomstick dildos, chanting tripping spells. I hurry past them into the gymnasium, where I'm instructed in the art of war by some jaded little Obi-Wan Kenobi. The little man with the yellow hat, carrying a scroll that is sealed with wax. The man in black with a jug of wine. Is it sour? Is it divine? The girl in blue with a silver flute. Her melody flies straight and true. The old priest with his soft words. All his sermons are filled with mirth. Ha! 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 The courtesan with the raven hair. All the young gods want to place their flowers there. Now I've been known to be a pain in the ass. Rattle my chains and drag the gates of hell right back. Drag out your Victrola. Oh, it's slow and sad, because this here muse could use some music to back it up. Three poems, because I don't want more poems, because I don't want the last two fucking things that are so vulgar. It's a beautiful.
Oh, come on.
Alright. This is vulgar if you hate fucking family farms. At the viewing, waiting for Uncle Barton's body suddenly to sputter and lurch to life. The way his old tractor did each spring. I know he is watching me when I turn on the tool shed's bare bulb, swinging by that ancient cord that disappears up into the dark rafters of that cathedral of bent nails, rust, and kerosene. He is whispering in the bottomland, and it is not just the wind in the pines, but him. Sometimes I hear him walking in the cornfield, just a few rows in, though I've never parted the stalks to look. I'm wholly sure that it is him. Uncle Burton found a lot of artifacts on his land, especially near the river. Old Catawba pottery sherds and arrowheads. When we were children, Uncle Burton would walk in the woods with my brother and me. He would tell us that he could hear the Indians singing in the river. That it wasn't just the water and the rocks, but voices. That he was wholly sure it was the singing of the first people to live there. Now, maybe a week before he died, I was out at the old farm, and Uncle Burton brought up the voices. He asked if I remembered him telling me about those Indians singing. Sure I did. My brother did, too. Well, said Uncle Burton, they're still there, but if they build that goddamn highway, won't nobody be able to hear them. Maybe not ever again. The old place had been renovated, rewired, but the ghost was still there. In the timbers, his voice, a loose piece of tin, conversing with a westerly wind. I put the key in the tractor's ignition, but it is his hand that turns it. Reaching into the Oliver's old toolbox, his arm reaches in too, helping me search out a block of wood, a length of chain. It was a good thing Uncle Burton had died a year ago happy. Instead of seeing the bottom land dissected by the bypass, the stream choked with debris, its special powers silenced by an oily film, the soccer fields replacing tobacco, chemicals green the turf, run off into the groundwater. They still get cancer, those kids. Their parents driving, doing all that driving. Used to be a night like this, was filled with nothing but croakers and lightning bugs. And now it's all brake lights and car horns. If man had been meant to drive, he'd have been born with his middle finger eternally sticking up. It was a good thing Uncle Burton had died a year ago happy. Train engineers don't even blow their own whistles anymore. Sure, it's safer, a computer never forgets, and maybe all that safety will give us space to spin vibrant, transcendent spider dreams, orbs of energy, or maybe we will just atrophy in a casing that lacks sweet sap. Nourishment. The power company murdered the mammoth oak in the pasture, paved it over, I sold the last of the cows, and become wholly convinced that Uncle Burton died a year ago happy. Woo!
Yeah. Woo! Oh, you got a great ass! Why don't you use it to make some money, or else in the eternal genocide in the darkest heart of Africa? You got a great ass. Why, with an ass like that, you could signal the aliens to come right on down here. They'd be more than pleased to meet us. Why, I bet you can shine a light right out of your perfect asshole and warn the great old tankers of treacherous rocks. Yeah!
Ted Pope, everybody. Wow. Man. Actually, I just went up to pay my tab, and I realized I'm a little bit light. Can anyone spot me 10 Tom Waits tours till Wednesday? Very good. Hell yeah. Man, very good. Hey, I want to remind you guys there is a lot of great work on the merch table that's in the very back corner of this room. Go check that out. There are several works from some of the poets that are on tonight's show. And also, I hope you guys have had some of the drinks on Crow and Quill put up a special drink menu for tonight. We got the Bukowski. We've got the green fuse, which says, surely what Dylan Thomas would have drank had he known of it. Plums and icebox and ode to William Carlos Williams. So, anyhow, check this out.
We don't have any of those.
They're out?
They're out of plums.
They're out of plums, all right. They're still the barbaric y'all. Check that out. I want to thank them. And we have some music coming up in a moment, but first we've got some burlesque. And now normally it's inappropriate to catcall and yell and wolf whistle at women, but unless it's a burlesque performance. All right, so don't be shy. I wanted to talk just a moment about parts of speech, like the article, right? Such as the and a. Makes a big difference. If I were to tell you that there is a girl with a derriere coming on stage, you're like, ah, big deal, it's common, right?
Yeah.
just another girl with a derriere, right? If I said there's a girl with the derriere, you'd be like, what's wrong with her derriere? Right? If I said the girl with a derriere, you'd be like, notable girl, common derriere, right? But our next performer is the girl with the derriere.
Right.
Please welcome Debonair.
Goes way up, and the weather is says
doing more push-ups over there during that. That's not another set of more push-ups. I want to thank everyone for coming out. We got one more song by Vedetta Cream. And, I want to go ahead and thank some people for coming out, man. I want to thank everyone for coming out. I want to thank the Crow and the Quill for sure. Give them a round of applause. Yeah. Thank you. I want to thank all the performers. Justin Evans, Lockie Hunter, Kevin Evans, Emilio Maldonado, Charlie Robb, who's going to be performing shortly, Michael Coyle, Lydia Shapiro, Eric Steiniger, Caleb Bysert, of course, Vedetta Cream, Ben Mack, Fire Eating, Kevin Barger, Very Sexy Man, Pasky Pasquale, Ted Pope, and of course, Kevin there. I want to thank everyone for...
Last time I did a show with you, you led all over the stage.
Yeah.
This show broke a parasail.
Yeah, I misled you earlier because that was not a rabbit's foot that you were.